Welcome to Weixin News, broadcasting at 11:30 p.m., Monday, November 27th. This is Fiona serving the news for you. Yijin is profound. It has been discussed numerously in many books from ancient to modern time. In Taiwan, hundreds of thousands of practical cases prove and verify the modernity of Yijin Feng Shui, which confers to the practicability in our real-life environment. Now, let's move on to today's Weixin Shenjiao feature story. Hello everyone, 阿弥陀佛. Welcome to Weixin Shenjiao feature story. Feng Shui exists everywhere in the universe, even in ourselves. No matter where we are, which era we are living in, we cannot escape from the influence of Feng Shui. Today, we are going to share a story that Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi witnessed. It is about building a pond in the back garden which used the wrong Feng Shui principles. A man who has a family of high income and well education living in southern Taiwan unfortunately encountered the turmoil and left one of the family members in desperation. By chance, he has introduced to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi by an enthusiastic friend. This man then piously invited Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi to survey the feng shui of his house. This man lives in a huge house. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi saw a beautiful pond upon he entering the front door. However, this beautiful pond looks like a man with a dislocating jaw. The house owner put so many stones of different heights in the pond. Some even looked really sharp. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi knew what had been bothering him before the man even uttered the word. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi asked him if all the family members suffered from throat problems. If not, then they must have argued with one another a lot. The house owner was very shocked by Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's statement and confirmed that his family members were suffering from not only unexplained throat pain, but also nasal and bronchial problems. Even though they had tried both Chinese medicine and the Western treatment for many years, nothing really had improved. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi told him that the problem came from the pond. The water flowed from the tiger side and then ran in front of his house. The rapid flowing water made a lot of noise, and the pond was filled with disordered and arc-shaped stones. In feng shui terminology, this is servant bully master, that is, you will be bullied by your guests. If the white tiger side of the garden is not quiet and still, the white tiger will cause inauspiciousness to the family. Then, the house owner opened up even more about his situation. Originally, his family was harmonious. In order to welcome his daughter-in-law and friends who were invited to attend the wedding ceremony, he asked someone to construct a new pond for beautifying the house's landscape. His wife and daughter-in-law argued and fought with each other every day, despite the daughter-in-law acted of filial piety to her original parents. Landscape and pond's construction would not match the balanced feng shui principles if the white tiger side of the garden does not stay quiet and still, and set stone disordered. The appearance of white tiger's claws will hurt the daughter-in-law and cause her to miscarry. The house owner kept nodding his head from Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's statement and confirmed his daughter-in-law was suffering a miscarriage. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi usually instructs us that we do not necessarily need a luxurious garden. A garden that corresponds to the feng shui principle is the key to a happy family. Thank you for watching today's feature story. See you next week. brought this with Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's footprint. Together, let's watch the footage of the rituals held at Xinzhu Dafan Branch Temple and the starting point of World Peace Taichung Branch Temple.
维新圣教 Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan师 instructed the course of rituals. By means of rituals, we may encounter Buddha, liberate and purify the souls of our ancestors as well as parents from generation to generation, and resolve grievances with karma creditors. Thus, we couldn't overemphasize the importance of rituals. Grandmaster attendant Medicine Buddha birthday celebration ritual at Dafan Branch Temple and the annual ritual at Taichung Branch Temple. At the altars, Grandmaster piously lit incense and prayed that the Dharma protectors of the heavenly dragons watch over the sentient beings, resolve clashes, and pacify wars. We hope for respect and admiration among mankind and for eternal world peace. On the 19th day of the month, accompanied with Master Yuan Chong, Grandmaster burnt incense in worship of Bezajagra and Bodhisattvas at the altar of Medicine Buddha birthday celebration ritual at Dafan Branch Temple. The next day, Grandmaster was present at the altar of the annual ritual at Taichung Branch Temple. Accompanied with Master Yuan Yi, Grandmaster lit incense in worship of Wangchan Laozhu and piously burnt incense and prayed in front of each lotus tablet.
今天我们大凡寺的周年法会、药师法会，还有台中道场世界和平原点的周年法会，这都是非常重要的。 大凡寺，药师殿，维新圣殿，药师佛的佛诞，这个是非常重要的一个维新圣教的法门，护佑整个的我们的中文所有贤士同修的平安。 还有护佑当地，还有台湾净土和家家户户平安，以及祈愿护佑世界和平，皆得平安。所以大凡寺由你们大师兄圆通禅师他来主谈。你们大师兄修养非常的好。 修养非常的，有忍辱，非常谦卑，这即是道的本质。希望各位维新贤士同修们，我们大家相互的勉励，相互的赞叹，不要相互的攻击，不要相互的毁谤，因为你不知道。 任何一个修行者，他背后他所带的天命，任何一位修行者，他来到世间上，他所要做的事情，究竟是什么呢？我们几乎有的不晓得。所以王禅老祖师尊开示我们，随顺因缘，一定会示现在世间，尤其在宗教的道场上。
In addition to lighting incense to worship all spirits listening to sutra at each tablet, Grandmaster set up and consecrated tablets for sakyan spirits dying from wars. He prayed Buddha and Bodhisattvas resolve the grievances of sakyan spirits and then led them to the pure land. Grandmaster instructs that if we owe others, we should reflect and confess ourselves sincerely. With confession of our sin accumulated from generation to generation in the presence of Buddha, we pray Buddha and Bodhisattva guide our karma creditors with mercy. By no means do we commit vice from now on. By doing so, the grievances and karma may be cleared. Weixin News.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
德威精业门窗，门窗权威指明德威，福中门造型典雅安全。
2015, the first annual disaster elimination and benediction ritual was held at the starting point of World Peace Taichung Branch Temple. It aimed to eliminate disasters, to stabilize the underworld and human world, and to pray for world peace. The 8th anniversary disaster elimination and benediction ritual started on November 18th and successfully completed on November 20th. Take a look.
维新圣教 Taichung Branch Temple held the Anniversary Disaster Elimination and Benediction Ritual from November 18th to 20th. On November 20th, they launched the Yoga Flaming Mouth Rites in the afternoon. The rites served offering tables for all attendants to invite their ancestor spirits, friends, karmic creditors, and the temple three realm spirits to accept bestowed food in the Dharma. They prayed that spirits could have ample food and clothing, be enlightened, and ascend to the pure land. This anniversary ritual was divinely ending by many people supporting. We are thankful to the Vedra Guru to administer the ritual. Masters and lecturers piously chanted sutras with holding wooden incense holder. All attendants sincerely had lotus seeds for their ancestor spirits to offer offerings. In addition, the virtuous fellow volunteers dedicated all their efforts to tirelessly working to ensure that ritual was successfully completed. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi joined the ritual. Master Yuan Yi accompanied Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi together to worship in front of altar, piously worship to each lotus seed. Sincerely pray Buddhas and Bodhisattva mercifully guided spirits to reborn in the Buddha pure land whenever those spirits could dissolve grievances and release karmic bonds. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi offered a speech to the intermediate class students about its causality and karma of anniversary ritual.
所以我们过去所造的恶业，我们都不，大部分都不会去。 体悟啊，不会去反省忏悔，所以我们就需要参加法会。参加法会不是说哎呀，佛啊，拜托拜托拜托，我让我怎么样啊？不是这样，你要在佛前求忏悔啊，请佛啊，请菩萨来跟你做主啊，请王禅老祖做主，帮你解冤释结。 这样才会解开，不然你要解开很困难，你要拿钱去请人家帮你拜忏，那个是不可能的事情啊。所以，我们维新贤士同学们，我们来读这么多的易经，易就是相对待，你怎么样的改变，你就会转到转化到什么光明天。若是我们不会依法来修行，我们所结的恶果。 绝对跑不了，这就是法会一年的功德天，要我们从借着法会的一年来做忏悔啊。
The causality of ritual is magnificent. All Weixin virtuous fellows and attendants could purify mentally by piously worshipping for repentance. We sincerely pray that Buddha and Bodhisattva benevolently bless us and fulfill our wishes. Weixin News Taichung Branch Temple.
Continue our news of rituals. Let's move on to Tainan Branch Temple to join the Basajia Guru Repentance Sutra ritual together.
On November 12, Weixin Shengjiao Tainan Branch Temple held the Basajia Guru Repentance Sutra ritual and prepared incense, flowers, fruits, and delicacy to make offerings to Dharma Realm. Start up in the morning. Master Yuan Xing and the chanters, guide ladies and gentlemen, recited the Sutra of the Medicine Buddha to invoke all divine beings to come down and praying for lighting up. May sentient beings could release karmic bonds and worries. May people be protected from harm, misfortune and sadness. May there be ever-present faith, safe and bright in the world. Master Yuan Xing was grateful to chanting virtuous pharaohs for guiding ladies and gentlemen, recited the Sutra of the Medicine Buddha.
So, 那在花边同修诵经甘露水不要观想在临界受生并来众仙为人来看看人家在祖先来祖灵来都会让他火焰化红眼成清凉地因为临体观这个平安你来的时候人观想你的颈椎处理因为你可以被前进的啊不管不管所有怒火火焰观清的消化
Master Yuan Xing said that if we confess by reciting the sutra, it is praying for their sour guts and family safety. In the manhole, there is a couplet said that, Worship the Buddha, could remedy and repair the wrong. Reciting the name of Amitabha Buddha one time to experience perfect compassion and wisdom, may good health prevail and be protected.And the blessing by Wang Chen Lao Zhu and the Medicine Buddhas as well. Weixin News, Tainan.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
世界新兴宗教台湾维新圣教禅机山仙佛寺义经大学草堂
For this week's education news,A Pride Language course of Weixin Shenjiao College held an outdoor teaching. Take a look.
Weixin Shenjiao Applied Literature class students went to Taichung to visit Taichung Bridge Temple and Weixin TV station on November 18th. First, they came to Ultimate Plaza to worship Wang Chen Lao Zhu. At the same time, Taichung Bridge Temple held an anniversary ritual. Every virtuous fellow worshipped every lotus seat with incense.Immediately, Master Yuan Yi introduced Taichung Bridge Temple to every virtuous fellow at the fifth floor classroom. Also, Master Yuan Yi told the story of how the Taichung Bridge Temple was built. The Master Yuan Ting of Weixin TV Station arranged the visiting process. Every staff of Weixin TV Station explained the situations of Weixin TV Station to let the students could know the process of recording,and broadcasting and the life of preaching affairs. Even a step of splicing and broadcasting control, the virtuous fellows who could just stay at home to see the TV can know the broadcasting process. Then understanding why the Grandmaster Huiyuan Chanshi set up the TV station, the practicing role is really difficult, so make people know how valuable to offer this platform for the virtuous fellows. Weixin News.Taichung Branch Temple.
Those who study Yi Jing should settle their minds when conducting themselves in the world and with others. Everyone who studies Yi Jing should be honest in their companies and to their customers. Weixin Shenjiao Yi Jing University opened a short-term Dajia Community Lecture at Taichung City on November 17th.Let's watch some footage of the lecture in Zhonggang Branch Temple.
Propagating Yi Jing Feng Shui, promoting the idea of learning Yi Jing, ensuring peace of all the families and achieving the harmony of our nation and society are the goals of Weixin Shenjiao Yi Jing University. To realize them, the masters and the lecturers have devoted themselves to many communities and opened free Dharma preaching lessons in the neighborhood to teach Yang House Feng Shui.The courses aim to raise the residents' attention to their surroundings and improve their living environment by using Yi Jing Feng Shui principles themselves. On November 17th, lecturer Yuan Mu and Yuan Zai of Yi Jing University Zhonggang Branch Temple opened the Dajia Dharma Preaching Community class at Shuntian Elementary School at Dajia District, Taichung City.They invited locals living in Dajia District to learn the knowledge of Feng Shui concerning their houses and take home the wonderful Dharma for their safety. The opening ceremony was hosted by Abbot Master Yuan Ran, Master Yuan Bing, Lecturer Yuan Pu, Lecturer Yuan Hu of Yi Jing University. All were present to extend their congratulatory messages. Master Yuan Ran spoke of the good cause he has planted with Dajia District after coming to Dajia under the order of Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi. Today, Lecturer Yuan Mu and Yuan Zai were continuing this great cause. Master Yuan Ran also encouraged the students that Feng Shui is not difficult. In fact, it is rather easy. Everyone can learn feng shui well and improve the feng shui of their houses and protect their families. Weixin News, Taichung.
The new religion of the world, Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao, is characterized with the modernity, practicability, and tolerability of the Yijing feng shui culture. Weixin English News is dedicated to provide our audience with diverse and abundant contents of Weixin world. Thank you for watching our program today. Stay tuned on every Monday at 11:30 p.m., every Tuesday at 11:30 a.m., and 4 o'clock p.m. Wang Chan Lao Zu bless you and your family. See you next week.